using school email, and you have that RBI kind of thing, so you can check both of the inbox and search over there as a manage back. If you write to manage back, you get a welcome email. Because I put all of your email IDs, especially school email ID, except for you who have already said that that email IDs are not working. I think you know, process it. Seriously, I put some in Gmail also. If it's totally not working, then only you can change.
Say go to Outlook and search for manage back. Okay.
Then you can use my charger.
You have?
Yeah, I have
charger. Your charger?
What is it? Okay,
sir. Can you just help them to get manage back welcome email?
16.
Because I am MIP 5 homeroom teacher. I do a
the other classes from your teacher, they can see the others. The next, if you go to the grade, this is for our exam purpose, town grade review. Okay, this is for an exam purpose, means whatever review will be there, whatever grades we have put it, once the session, our exam will be done, that time we are going to fill up over here. This will be available for all the teachers. If you just select YBMOIP years or this one, so that time we have to create. See, the student name is showing over here for me. So since the class teacher can see what are the grades they have got and if there is anything pending, they can get the access over here. Okay, next I'm going for CAS, SA for submission action. Okay, for standard level, anything we have over here, the programs, these programs, if you okay, now you are going for CAS and personal project. Right now we have, right now we are having for MIP 5 personal project only. That's why it is showing MIP 5 here. Okay? All the students, like for me, Adish is my student. So it will be shown over there. If you are a supervisor of personal project, your student name will be shown over there. All of you please check it. Your student name is with you or not. Here, it is here. Project, click on project, then MIP 5 is there. Click on that. Go over here, the third and fourth one. Project ETOK. Click over there. Then it will open class one. 20. Then you are a supervisor or anything?
No.
Class of 2022 MIP 5. Is it showing over there? Got it? Who are the supervisor? They have got it?
No, I
class of 2022
is it.
It is 1925.
We'll change the date, sir. That is not a matter. Just for adjustment, we have given that. So this one is MIP 5, like for me, my student is showing over here. Okay?
Now in this class,
if you go to member, this is student members. Then you are going for home room advisor. If you go over there, it will show your name if you are home room. See, my name is shown over here. Okay? Now if you SA advisor, services action advisor, if you go over there, Arthur Kumar's name will be shown over there. Please check it. Is there? All of you? There? Okay. Now if you go over there, PP supervisor. These are the PP supervisor. Personal project supervisor name will be showcased here. Okay? Next is, next we are going to see that the subject. Okay, now attendance things, once you are done with this, this is ready for attendance, you can check with, if you go over there, there is attendance manager. Okay, if you click over here, attendance manager, right now we are not taking attendance, just for your understanding I will show you over here. Home room, if you go over here, whatever classes you are home room, suppose for me it is MIP 5, I am checking in grade 10. Okay? Because I need middle school and grade 10, that is MIP 5. If you click over here, 1st October, if you click over here, student name will be shown over here. From here, you can put the comments also that if you have received anything, email or medical certificate or anything, at the, for this purpose, student is absent, you can mention over there. Even at the result, if you want to show that one, these are the number of percentage and this is the attendance sheet, you can add over here. Okay. The next, the major task, that is the unit plan. Okay. The unit plan, that will take little more time, that was. If you go to dashboard for unit plan, it will take a little time. I have done one sample unit plan, but for you create your unit plan, if you click over there, it will show you a page like this. Okay, title, unit title. Unit title, which month you are going to start. How many weeks you are going to take it? And how many hours you are giving? Like you know that we have a template where the number of hours, number of weeks has been mentioned over there. Okay? And since you are doing for grade 10, so automatically it will take it for MIP 5. Okay? And it's already written that IP, MIP standard numbers. For me, it is showing standard numbers. We are offering the students of standard numbers. As per your subject choice, you can also change it. Now what are the grades you are taking? Next one, course part. Course part is the content. Whatever things you are, like algebra for me. First course unit part is algebra. Right, unit title also I can put algebra. In the algebra, what are the things I am going to teach? You can put over there. Yeah, algebra I am not going to teach everything. Like if it is there for higher levels also, like degree level, that I am not going to teach. I am going to teach some portions. So those title you can put it as a course part. Okay? Thereafter, once you create the unit plan, if it is done, click on create unit. Once you click on create unit, one of the things, since I have created one sample unit, so it will be look like this. Like statistics and probability, that was my title that I am going to teach this one. Okay, once it is, if create unit is done, so better you can do one thing, you can open one of your unit plan and try to put one by one. So at a time, you can place at least like one unit plan, 10 minutes.
Broad outline.
product for that topic.
Yeah, like
this
is
chapter.
Like a chapter.
That's good.
That, this one here watching it. Unit typing.
Yeah, unit typing is good. In the unit there are some chapter, right?
Whole data there, right?
So at least tentatively one unit plan will be in the place. Okay? We're doing for MRP 5, right? MRP 1. So you go over here. So I think when I get to suppose you are taking for some level, like your language has some phases, right? Then we can delete. It has given multiple options. Like suppose Sarah is taking for physics for different level of students. Different shape you can do that. So some students are in MIP 3, some students are in MIP 5. Okay. So you are taking for English for MIP 1, MIP 2, MIP 3, MIP 4, MIP 5. Now here there are some sections of like A, B, C, D. So there will be multiple sections. You can choose any of one. Yes. Open one of your unit plan, give its title. Once this title is done, yeah, give a title, whatever topic you want.
Description of the relationship, it will be automatically in place.
Now, if you go to your, once again, your unit plan, you check that related concept. I have two related concepts. Another one is representation and the justification. So, you go over here, related concept, I can choose justification and representation. Just check the box.
Next.
scholarly statement of inquiry. So there are multiple options are there. In this inquiry question, there are factual question, conceptual question, debatable questions, you can put the question. And there is one more thing is here. If I go over there, there is a line of inquiry. Now normally, in our inquiry plan, we haven't put here line of inquiry. We are using
factual question. It is not
PYP. So you can keep this space blank. Okay, you can put in question as per like factual question or debatable question. Once the factual question is done, once again you can click on an add inquiry question, then you can put for conceptual and everything under this drop down list. You click over there.
Now when you said add inquiry question.
So suppose this is the factual question I have added. Now add inquiry question, go over here, conceptual question, again add inquiry question, go over here, give it a question.
So, but then is it that also factual question can be more than one?
Factual question if it is more than one.
No, add a question is that also. We need not to go for another type of question. Suppose I want to add a factual question.
Yes, you can click on the factual
question. And then
you can put the question. Suppose you want to put three factual questions. So more adding, the more you want to.
So you are doing that. What I have done, I have any question for.
When you are taking
add, so you will show over here add a sentence. If you want like that, that's your choice.
See, even
those
gaps there,
like that. Mm-hmm. But still, it will show like the same way, whatever I am putting. If you want a, like a column wise, so you can choose differently.
No, sir.
Go to curriculum, there's a column over here after stream and resource. hence find over here the calculum. If you click over here calculum, it will be here. Like for mathematics, since I have entered here the mathematics.
So it is only so objective.
Yeah, first is objective. Now objective, standard, content and skills. Everything over there. Like I have four criteria, the four criteria objective has been shown over here. Now next thing is when you are making assessment task. Suppose you are taking some particular strength. Now here it is suppose applying mathematics to real life context. I am not going to check everything. Only suppose things and maybe check.
That is what formative. For formative,
yes, formative or something, you can just put those check box. So that will be reflected in your task sheet. When there is a student login also. Suppose you have given, so student will get a notification. They will open up, okay, and they will get the task. Then they can solve whatever things. So already task sheet will be you can make through this software.
But this is applicable only all of you. It is applicable only formative. Summative you can't escape any.
Summative.
Whatever the objective you have selected for that unit. So summative. अगर आपने दो objective लिए हैं.
And submitting, if you have to go for submitting, click on the first box, so automatically everything will be there. Okay, all the objectives will be there. Next, we are going for standard. What are the things you are expected, like we are giving, what's that? Teacher. Expectation or something you write.
Start task specific.
Task specific clarification.
You don't have to use proper terminology.
Staff specific clarification, that where you can put it over here. And content sense to you, what are the expected ATL or what are the content you are doing for assessment. Okay.
So standards are task specific.
So next why
for the standard? Are you sure standards then class specific clarification?
Yep. What is
so
the expectation?
So
you
need to give that grade wise? Like band wise, band 1 and 2, 3 and 4. We have, we give that grade
wise. So same thing, like 1 and 2, ke liye aap IB ke grade descriptor likha hua hai, right hand corner we have our class specific, so we can review.
Like we have a unique plan for guests and prior knowledge days, learning experiences, student expectation. We have beginning of the unit, between the unit and end of the unit, and these are the things also can change. It's literally different, like with the beginning and all the same.
No, this I got it. I'm asking for standards. You said we need to give task specific.
Like you are selecting for selected objective, right? So two objectives you are giving. Based on that, you are putting some standards.
But that will go. I'll have some different task descriptors for my second formative, and then in the summative it will be different depending on the task. So under standards, how will I put that? Like, or will I put only the highest band one?
I think bus.